Yeah, welcome to our class again for the beginner programming for kids, course one. This is unit 1.4. And in this unit, we are going to talk about something very special, okay? I'm going to talk about the great question. Now, the last time I told you that, in the last class, I told you that who programmers are and what is a program. And I know that your mind was like, can I do this? Now the great question, what is the great question is what we'll look at today, okay? Very good. Now the great question normally is, can I become a programmer? Yes, it's scary, you know. Sometimes people have said a lot, to become a computer programmer, you need to be this, you need to be that, you need to be that, you must not sleep, you must not eat, you must not that, but is that the truth? No, that is not the truth, my dear. The truth is that you can become a programmer. And then the next question will be, am I not too young to be a programmer? No, you are not too young. Is that okay? You are not too young. At your age, you can learn to become a programmer. The only thing is that it's step by step. So that's why we are introducing you to this beginner programming for kids course one that will help you develop the necessary skill that will take you to the next level. So it's going to be level by level. Is that okay? Very good. But there are some things that you would need to do, some qualities you will need to have to become a great programmer. The first one is that programmers or coders think ahead. You must learn to think ahead. Is that okay? All these things, I will guide you to learn and to start doing them all through this course. Is that okay? So don't be scared. Don't say, how am I going to learn these qualities? No, I will teach you how to get this what? Qualities. You must learn to think ahead. Thinking ahead means when you have a problem, you must see the end result. What end result do you want? You must try to understand what you want to what you want to do. Is that okay? And then secondly, you must learn to break things down. Coders or programmers are people who are able to break things down. Good. Let's say, for example, I want to build a program that is like this. I must learn to break things down into various parts. I must learn to do level one, level two, level three, and at the end, I will get the entire result. Is that okay? You must not just want to do everything all at once. No. Break things down and do it bit by bit. That is what programmers do. And also, number three, you must be careful. Programmers are careful people. They try not to make mistakes because mistakes can be costly. Imagine I've designed a program that say it can check when somebody is sick so that the doctor can attend to the person. And then I make a mistake and the person is sick and the program is not able to identify that the person is sick. What happens? That person will die off. And we don't want that. So when we design programs, we must be very careful. So you must learn to be careful. And also we must be imaginative. Imaginative. What I mean is that you must try to look at things and think far and try to see things that other people are not seeing. For example, I want to design a program that can call people by their name. I must now begin to imagine, how can I do that? How can the program know this person's name? How can the program know that this person is not this person? You must be imaginative. Is that okay? Yes, it's not difficult to learn. Uncle Christian is going to guide you. Is that okay? Very good. But the only thing I will need is that you need to follow me. Is that okay? Good. And then lastly, some people will say, oh, these things are difficult. I'm not doing it again. Mommy, I will not learn to be a programmer again. Next step or next quality you must have in order to be a great programmer is that you must not give up. You must be patient and persistent. What that means is that even if it's difficult, you must stay put, stay strong. Good, you must stay strong. Is that okay? Good, don't give up. Now, there are some times I must be truthful to you that a problem will be difficult and you don't know what to do, but you continue to stay put, you continue to think. You continue to imagine. Come on, good. Is that okay? Now, when you do these five things, then you're on the road to becoming a great programmer. And I'm there to guide you. So I'm going to see you in the next lesson, in the next unit, where we are going to talk about what? Another interesting topic, but now I need you to be happy knowing that you can become a great programmer. Is that okay? Very good. In the next unit, we are going to look at the benefits of becoming a programmer. So see you. Have a nice time. I'm going to thank mommy and daddy for buying you this course because you're on the road to achieving something great. See you later. Bye-bye.